Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. You're watching hashtag Saturday Study Talks, where every Saturday I'll be answering your questions, questions related to education, questions related to career guidance, and as well as personal questions. So let's begin our video. First question is from Shiva M. Ma'am, I have a doubt. I'm an aspirant of AP ESET 2019. My category is SC. How many marks I'll get admission into universities like OU and JNTUH? I got 130 marks in AP ESET 2019. So this is his question. He got 130 marks. Okay, Shiva, you got 130 marks. You're asking whether you'll get admission from, like, for these marks, will you get admission for the colleges, like the universities like OU and JNTUH? So coming to ESET, for JNTU, if you want, as your SC, if you want to get admission into JNTU college, like the university, you have to at least get the rank below 1000. And the thing is, you didn't mention your rank here. You just told that you got so and so marks. So according to my knowledge, you have to at least get 1000 below rank if you want to get an admission in JNTU college, university. And coming to OU, like if you want to get admitted, if you want to get admission in OU, then you have to get at least a rank below 2500 to 3000. Like you have to get the rank below these numbers so that you'll get the admission in OU. And whereas for general students, like the general category students, they have to at least get 1600 rank or 1500 rank to get a seat in OU. And if it is for ST, they have to get at least below 2200 rank. And whereas if a student is BC, then the rank should be at least below 4000 to 4500. Okay, actually the number changes based upon the competition. Like every year the competition will be differing, so the ranks also will be differing. These are the approximate ranks. So all the best, Shiva M. And next question is from Edgerton Sconner. Sir, can you please tell me which college will I get if I get 76 marks in COMEDK exam? I am non-Karnataka OBC and should I take it? Okay, so first of all, I'm not sir, I'm ma'am. Can you please tell me which college will I get if I get 76 marks in COMEDK? Like, you know, these people, and he's, and this person is OBC and also non-Karnataka, so he's not non-Karnataka. So I am, you didn't mention your rank here. You just told like your you got, you're expecting or got, you didn't mention here, like 76 marks, you didn't mention your rank here. So I'm just telling you a few of the topmost colleges where there are, like, you know, for a particular college there will be certain cutoff, and if your rank is beyond, like, you know, less than the particular cutoff, then you will easily get admission into that particular college. And if your rank is beyond it, then you have to search for another college. So here I'm expecting, as you got 76 marks, your rank may be more than 20,000. So I'm just telling you few colleges where you can get the seat for 20,000 rank or about 20,000 rank. PES, Institute of Technology, Bangalore is one of the engineering college which will acquire the students if they got the rank about 20,000 also. So that is one of the college. I'm repeating the name. It is PES, Institute of Technology. And some other colleges are MS Ramaya Institute of Technology, though if you get if you get 30,000 rank also, it will accept your admission. And another college is Sri Jayachamara Rajendra College of Engineering. If you get 29,000 place rank also, it will admit you. And some other colleges are Sri M Visveswaraya Institute of Technology. The starting rank is 622 and the ending rank is 33,548. So if your rank is in between this limit, you will be admitted into this college also. And a few other colleges are Dayananda Sagar College of Engineering. If you get the rank below 40,000 also, you can get admitted into this college. And National Institute of Engineering. So if you want to get an admission, or if you are seeking an admission to this National Institute of Engineering College, this is located in Mysore, and your rank should be minimum of 2783, and the maximum rank which this college admits is 39,000 ranks. So based upon your rank, you can choose a college which suits you and which you like. And next question is Technology Odisha. The question is from Technology Odisha. Hello ma'am, now I'm studying BSc Physics, but I think to be a software engineer. So what should I study after BSc? Yes, coming to this question, 2 to 3 people asked me, what should I do after BSc? So let's see those questions also. After those questions, I'll give a complete solution for all these three questions. So let's go to next question also. The question is from Sadia Sahil. Ma'am, I'm a graduate in BSc Chemistry. I don't want to do MSc in Chemistry. I am in a confusion between MCA and MBA. Is MCA an distant degree course? And there's one more question. It is also related to the BSc only. So let's see that question. It's from Mohammed Nasser. Hi ma'am, I have completed BSc MScS, well studied. Further, which group is best for my career? MBA or MCA or MSc? Please guide me, awaiting for your reply. Okay, so I am giving the common solution for all these three people. So as you are from MSc, you are from the science background, and I am going to tell you what are the jobs available if you choose MSc as your PG. Like as you are from BSc, next if you choose MSc, these are the different careers which are available for you. I'm reading out the careers. If you choose MSc, you can get a bank job, you can get a job in a government sector, you can even work for the private sector MNCs, and you can work as a professor, you can work for railways, you can also work in research related jobs, and you can also work in ONGC, HPCL, etc. And even ISRO, BHEL will also provide jobs for MSc students. And these are the companies and these are the sectors which provide jobs for MSc. And I am now going to tell you few job profiles, few job roles which you can work as an MSc. If you are an MNC postgraduate, these are the job profiles which are available for you. Like you can work as a manager, you can work as an accountant, you can work as a researcher and assistant professor, software engineer, manager, accountant, statistician and all. And here are the few MNCs which will recruit MSE students, that is GAIL, ONGC, ICICI, Oracle, Wipro, Infosys, HCL, etc. These are the companies which will recruit the people from MSc. And for an MSc holder, the average package, like the starting package, will be around 3 lakhs. It differs from your knowledge, it differs from your college. If your college is really good college, then your package may be really high, because for reputed colleges, the companies will really offer more and more packages, and the average salary of MSc students will differ from 25,000 to 35,000 per month. And so these are the careers which are available for MSc students. And for MCA, you can be a professor, you can be a software engineer, web designer, web developer, application developer, and you can also be a business analyst and software engineer, software designer, and all the things relating to software. And if you choose MBA after BSc, then you have to you have to work a little harder, because it contains all commerce related subjects. And for MBA, you can be an accountant, you can be a chartered, if you are interested in CA, just I don't think so now you can go, because that is not the career which you need to choose now, because for CA you have to write CPT after 12th, so that career is not available now. And for MBA, more careers which are available are like accountant and business analyst also, and marketing, sales, production, finance, banking sectors, government sectors. You can also apply for government jobs, all that. So based upon your interest, just choose your career after BSc, whether you would like to go to MSc or MCA or MBA. It's completely your choice, like which career you wanted to choose. And my suggestion is that more than MSc, if you go for MCA, you'll get relatively high packages, because MCA is having a high value, like little bit of more value compared to MSc. So based upon that, you please choose your career. So these are the three possibilities which I told you. And next question is from Ramu Mohan. Could you please upload Ripley question papers? You didn't mention what subjects and all. If it is IEEE, I already have that on my channel. If it's IEEE question papers, just mention what are the subjects you would like me to upload, so I'll surely upload it ASAP. And coming to next question, it is from Shruti Maharaju. I think it's Maharaju, I don't know. Shruti Maharaju. Can we do MCA or MBA PG courses at distance level? Yes, you can surely do MBA or MCA in distance, but the thing is, if you do these courses in distance, those will have really less value. It is not that, most of the colleges, most of the companies don't even accept the students from, who did their PGs or who did their graduation at distance, because it is not having that value. Like, it does not have high value when compared to the students who go to college and attend the classes. And the thing is, coming to MCA, I suggest you not to do at distance, because it does not have value. If you do at distance, it is always better if you go to college and pursue from the college, and make sure you select a good college, because the reputation of your college really helps while placements and coming to MBA. If you're really deciding yourself to go into MBA, then make sure you go to business schools, because business schools really has high weightage coming to your career. They provide you a minimum 4 to 5 lakhs package, like average 4 to 5 lakh package. It also reaches to 20 lakh package per annum if it is high, like, you know, if it is like IBS and all. And make sure you go to business school, and if it is the normal college also, choose a college which is having good reputation and high placements and all, and good feedback. Otherwise you'll end up having just your certificate, because normal colleges will not provide good placements for MBA. So here begins with the personal questions. So let's start. Best thing and worst thing about being a YouTuber. Okay. Best thing and worst thing of being a YouTuber is, best thing is that I can connect to many students. Like, you know, I can help many students. I can guide them. I can, you know, I can have a conversation with strangers, and I can learn many things because of YouTube. And the best thing is I got to get many subscribers, many viewers, many followers. I'm very glad for that. And worst thing of being a YouTuber, I didn't find any worst thing. No, till now, I'm really glad with being a YouTuber. I've never had at least one worst thing of being a YouTuber. But the thing is, if you are really interested to be a YouTuber, if you are passionate of being a YouTuber, then you will not find any worst thing of being a YouTuber. So it's my passion, so I didn't find anything. So next question is, any advice for new YouTubers? Okay, so first decide what type of channel you want to create, like whether it is an entertainment, whether it is a study related, whether it is flash, like fashion blog, or whether it is accessories, beauty, or whether it is a gaming channel. So first decide what channel you want to start, and then make sure you choose the name which attracts, you know, the name which you choose should be attractive and should be easy to pronounce and easy to type. And the thing is, the name of your YouTube channel should be short as possible, like as short as possible, so that it will be easy while typing. And next thing is, the content which you put on your YouTube really matters. It should be your unique content. If you copy and put it, you'll get a copyright strikes and all. So it should be unique, and the content should be attractive, and your content should connect to your subscribers and the viewers. And that's it. It's easy. And make sure if you're really interested, then only come to YouTube, because, you know, in the early days, you can't expect any money or like any revenue from YouTube. You have to work hard for at least 1 year. Then only you'll start earning. And YouTube support team, there's one team called YouTube support team. Whatever queries you have regarding YouTube, it will really help you in getting the answers of that queries. And if you mail them, you'll get the reply within less than 1 day, like 24 hours. So next question is, what is your favorite channel? What channel? YouTube channel. My channel is my favorite channel always. And I love many other channels. Like I do watch many other entertaining channels, like, you know, and I also watch the channels like Mostly Sane and Superwoman, all those stuff. I just and in Filter Copy, some other channels which I like are Life Tuck, Scoop Whoop. All these channels I love. I'm fond of those channels. They are all entertaining channels. And coming to educational channels, my channel is all-time favorite for me. When is your birthday? My birthday is on January 13th. When did you start making YouTube videos? I created Best Way to Study on December 17th, 2000, December 17, 2017. Yeah, 2017. But as soon as I created the channel, I didn't make any videos. I took time. And from 2018, I started uploading videos. And nowadays, I'm uploading many videos a week. But then I used to not do that. I used to upload a particular video, like one particular video for a week, and sometimes one video a month. Now it's been speed up. Like, it's my channel is in a way of boosting up. I'm so glad that people are connecting to my channel and people are commenting their queries, whatever they have, in the comment section below. And I make sure how like whenever I'm busy, I make sure at least I upload one video at least for 2 to 3 days. Like for a week, I'm uploading at least 2 to 3 videos nowadays. And I'll make sure I read each and every comment. Like though I have thousands of comments, I read every comment and I make sure I answer your questions. So do hate comments hurt you? So by God's grace, 99% of my comments will be like, they'll ask questions to make a particular video, or they ask questions regarding their career guidance. They ask questions and they like my video. They compliment me. They compliment the video. And only 0.1% of the people, like, they are actually like very less hate comments, and I just ignore those hate comments because when there is 99.9% of love which is coming from you people, why will I feel sad for that 0.1% of hate comments? I just block them and I just delete them. That's it. Do you believe in superstitions? Yes, I do believe in superstitions, but there's a limit for my belief in superstitions. I am not that blind believer, and it's the personal choice of a person. Next question is, how to succeed in life? How to succeed in life, in the sense, if it is coming to education, if you're a student, then you have to study hard, you have to work hard, you have to, like, not just your bookish knowledge, you have to learn beyond the book, and you have to even gain the practical knowledge, because nowadays corporate world, like, the industry is expecting the practical knowledge from the students. So make sure you also do internships and all. And coming to this question, if it is, if the, like, there's no name, the person, how to succeed in life, if you're an employee, then what you need to do is you have to first do the things which you love to do, then automatically success follows you, because you have to first believe in yourself. And yeah, I forgot to tell you one thing. There are about 10 to 15 comments last week which asked me what is the best way to crack a job. So I didn't mention that comment, like, because I thought to discuss this particularly in end of my video. So the thing is, see, if you want to get a job, first what you need to do is you have to crack the first level of the job, which is written test. Any company, whether it is online or offline, will conduct you the written test. Okay, So coming to written test, we call it as CRT, Campus Recruitment Training, that is called CRT. So this particular course will cover the written test, all the topics of written test. So if you go to CRT training, you can easily crack the written test. And once you crack the written test, few companies, second round will be group discussion. So in group discussion, the person who is mentoring, like you know, who is monitoring your attitude and your words, like the things which you speak, everything will be monitored by a person who is sitting there next to you. Like you know, next to you means the person who is monitoring you sees your body language, what are you speaking, and he or she also makes sure that you are giving a chance to others to speak. You're not dominating. So all these things, because you know, coming to job, we are not only the person who works. You will have to work in a team. So you have to cope up with the people. So that behavior is there or not in you. That also will be observed by the person. And the third round will be like few companies will have technical round as the second round, and few companies will have group discussion as second round, and the final round will be HR round, personal interview. For few companies, the personal interview and the technical interview will be together. In technical interview, the questions will be asked related to your core subjects. And coming to HR, the questions will be asked like, tell me about yourself, why should we hire you, and all about yourself. They'll be asking like basic questions. There's no need to get tensed. And the thing is, like among the three rounds which I told you, the first round is the most hardest round to crack, because it's not that easy. Without practice, you can make it. Okay, so that is the most filtering round. Like if 1,000 people attend to the first round, only 200 to 300 of the students will be promoted to the second round. It's first round is the toughest round, I can say. And few companies will also have the rounds like email writing, telephonic interview, and all that. So yeah, I forgot to tell, most of the students are also asking me what is the best way to crack aptitude, like CRT. The first thing is you have to go to training. Like you know, you can't prepare by yourself unless you are like, you know, if you start preparing at least from 6 months, then you can crack the aptitude round, like the CRT round. And if you're a student and if you're a newcomer, then it's suggested for you to just go to the training. And yeah, most of the students also comment me to tell me what is the best CRT training center. Yes, I personally researched on this, like last 10 days I personally researched to tell you what is the best CRT training. And there is this one site called setyourrank.com, SETYOURRANK.com, setyourrank.com. So I personally researched on this setyourrank.com. They are providing CRT training, and I also saw what are the contents of the training. This CRT training it is online training, and it's nice that they are providing you CRT online training just within a month. And they also mentioned in their website that they covered the personal interview, technical interview, and group discussion techniques and all. So I suggest my students, like my subscribers, to just check out the channel. This is not promotion of anything. They didn't pay me. I'm just telling this channel, like this site name, because it really attracted me, because they are providing the CRT training just for $9.99, which is the basic affordable thing. So that is very good. Like setyourrank.com, the name is setyourrank.com. Yeah, and they also provided Java training just for $9.99. So spoken English, all those stuff, like when I went through that channel, I saw all those things. So this is one of the really good site which is providing the online training at affordable price. So that is so good. So I suggest just check out that site. If you feel useful, just go for it, because CRT is really hard to crack by yourself. So you need to go to training. So this is one of the wonderful site, like setyourrank.com. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Like, I'm getting thousands and thousands of views, but very less subscribers. So please, you are viewing my channel, so don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, like, hit like, and share this video to all your friends and help them out. If you have any queries, just comment me in the comment section below. Every Saturday, I'll be answering your questions. So see you on next Saturday with hashtag Saturday Study Talks. Thank you so much for watching this video. And for IEEE papers like Java projects, and for major projects, IEEE projects, mini projects, you can mail me to bestwaytostudy7@gmail.com. The mail address is also available in the description below. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Comment me in the comment section below how you felt this video, and if you have any queries, if you have any personal questions, also feel free to comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this video. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. Bye bye.